The most common blockages outside the heart tend to be in the legs, and they're very common in smokers and diabetic. The symptoms are called claudication, which is basically discomfort when people walk. And because of that, a lot of time patients don't even seek medical attention for that because they think this is just the symptoms of arthritis, getting old, muscle pain, and so forth. So unfortunately, a lot of time goes unrecognized because the patient don't mention it during their routine physical or visit with their primary care physician or occasionally even with the cardiologist. There's this expectation that as we get older, things should hurt when we walk. It's a pain with walking, as I mentioned, and it usually consistent, happen at the same distance all the time, and it get to the point it's bad, feels like a cramp where people have to stop. And typical to the claudication, when they stop, the pain goes away, and usually the amount of time it takes for the pain to go away is consistent as well. So people will say, I usually walk 2 blocks, I get the pain, I have to stop, and then 2-5 minutes after I stop, the pain goes away and I'll be able to walk again. Typically does not happen when people are sitting or laying down, unless it's a really advanced phase where the blockage is so severe to start to cause pain, even without walking or doing activities. It's the same concept. It starts by defining the blockage, the exact location, the severity of it, how many blockage, and the way we do that is through what we call an angiogram, which is similar to heart catheterization in the sense you put a catheter and inject contrast, except now we're not looking at the heart, we're looking at the legs or whatever location we suspect that there's blockage there. Once we establish there's blockage, then it becomes an issue. What's the best way to treat it? And it's the same as in the heart. Some blockage are better served with medication and exercise. Some blockage will need surgery to fix, and some blockage could be fixed with the balloon and stent. Which one is the appropriate approach? It's a technical issue. You really have to see the blockage to make that determination. Big percentage of patients who have blockages in their legs and outside the heart have a higher risk of having blockage in the heart and vice versa. Disease process, it's the same. It's what we talked about, cholesterol buildup and interruption in that smooth layer that line our arteries, whether it's in the heart or outside the heart. The risk factors are the same to cause heart problems or blockages outside the heart. So smoking, diabetes, high blood pressure, family history. Really, there's a lot of overlap between the two conditions.